from? You mean primary school?
No, father's lesson. What would it be?
We'll have techniques of definite integral. Chapter 2. Special functions.
Now we're at beta function, right?
Together with gamma function that we have learned.
Yes.
So, we'll use some questions to test for our knowledge of these beta function and
gamma function.
Yes.
So, one of the questions, let me just say that it's a beta and one of it is a gamma.
Yes, okay. So first, let's look at the first question.
So, would you solve it?
Okay, so you want me to solve it?
Next one down.
No problem. So first question. Let's see. We have integrated from 0 all the way to 1 over 5.
And wait, the second, the boundary is wrong. Here, only 1 minus 5. Here, only 1 minus x, not 1 minus 5x. So, what do we do?
So, wait, just looking at this form, you can realize that it is a beta function.
Of course. But how to change it into a beta function? That's the problem. So the question for the integral from 0 to, can you just write down the question first? Integral from, don't write that high anyway. Integral from 0 to 1 over 5, bracket 4x bracket cube, bracket 1 minus 5x bracket square dx. So for this question, shall we factorize?
That's dumb.
Shall we binomial expansion?
That's even worse.
Then should we can we straight away integrate?
That's even more worse.
So should we sub?
Substitution.
Yes, but what should we sub? Using the
read this.
Let 5x equals to y. X equal to 5 over... I mean y over 5, I meant. And dx equal to dy over 5. Then y's range is 0 to 1, and then we need to find one. Just kidding, we already found it. Wait a second, why is it 0 to 0? 0 to 0. This is what 0 to 0 means. For example, this graph, this is 0. 0 to 0 means here. That's the dot. No way.
So for this, what else? Are we missing anything?
I think so.
Then what? I don't see anything missing.
Let me see first. Oi! This, yes, much better. You could take it out. That's much better.
So it becomes like this?
Yes.
And then y cubed. So when you want to change it into beta function, you have to add one.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Becomes like this. And anyway, why is it a 625? Can you explain that?
Here also need time. After that, this still got this part.
So 5 to the power of 4, right? That is 25 times 25, that is a 625.
Okay.
Are this is it right?
Yep.
Because this formula we have proven before, correct?
Yes.
And here the gamma, we also have proven this before. Right?
Of course. Yes.
So, next. Like this, right?
Yep.
Then can we simplify?
Okay.
So 4 and these will simplify, 3 and these will simplify. So we have another 4, we'll simplify with this. Now what are we left with? Okay, so we have 15 here. We need to work that out with algorithm working.
Yep.
So, what we got is a 16 over 9375.
Yep.
Now, this is actually quite simple. So, is this our answer?
Okay, so we will have two methods. First method, substitution. Second method, you say it's very dumb, but I don't want you to do it, the binomial expansion. It was like very dumb. So what do you say?
You sure about that?
Yes. Training your brain, even though it's the dumbest method training. The first method very easily, then you got the answer, but the second method, binomial expansion.
Whoa, so long! Phew! Luckily, this is a smaller power.
But why we don't want bigger power then?
Then, we have to write everything out. Imagine that.
So, best is not to use the binomial, but we'll just give you an example if we use the binomial, okay? Don't be that dumb to use the binomial.
Yes?
What are you using? Split?
Now I'm separating it now.
Yeah.
So then 25. 64 times 25. Now I will slowly work that out. Don't need to hurry.
But in competition, you must hurry.
Okay, so for this. Now at this part, can we integrate?
Yappy, yappy, yappy. Yay.
Correct, like this?
Correct!
Now, this is a lot of hard work, right? You have to watch carefully without blinking your eyes.
That means we need to open our eyes as big as an owl's eyes.
So, 0 sub n is totally useless. Now it's 1 over 5 only. what is 5 to the power of 4?
5 to the power of 4 is
6 to 5, right?
6 to 5, yes.
Then what do we have? Here, simplify. What do we get? Hello, what do we get?
So simplify it.
1 to 8.
1 to 8.
Times 1 over. What's 5 to the power of 5? 3, 1, 2, 5, right?
Yeah.
Oh, this is going to be quite a lot of work, right?
This.
Then plus, so you can simplify it to?
Yep.
800 over 3 times 5 to the power of 6. So times 5 here. 1, 5, 6, 2, 5. Like this. So next year, realize we can still simplify. Well, because this it looks so complicated. So we'll just write it down here. So this will become 7.
Well, I will help you, okay?
No.
Why?
I say this part is a little bit wrong. Like this, simplify. Like this. Right? Then we can simplify one more time.
Ow.
So what happens when here you simplify? Okay, so we got 32. So what is the common denominator?
Oh.
Yes. What is your common denominator? Okay, so it's actually very easy. Here is 5 to the power of 5, right? So this one, you need it. And here we have 3, we need it. So that makes 9, 3, 7, 5 as our common denominator. So that means here, 16, you need to times 5, then times 3.
Wait a second.
Yes, any problem?
Some change.
16 times 5 times 3, that is 80.
Okay.
80 times 3 is 2.0. Then you have to minus, so this times, this part times 3. 384 plus. So at this part, you just need extra 5. Like this. So then just try to cancel them out. And what I got is a 16 over 9, 375. Same answer. Correct.
Yes.
So this is the first question. So you see, when you got the wrong method, it actually means that the working might be quite hard and the calculation might be quite hard. Don't just think, wait, isn't this longer? No, you don't do like that. Because this I skip quite a lot, right?
Like,
right?
Like
so this skips quite a lot, right?
Yes.
So you have to be careful of the method.
So, but sometimes some methods quite complicated even though correct. Some methods not complicated also correct. Some methods complicated and long. Some methods not complicated but wrong.
Okay, so you have to be careful of your method. Now, time for the second question.
And of course, you shouldn't use partial fraction. That's too dumb.
Partial fraction, where do you get a fraction here? Unless you say over 1, then
stupid.
Now, time for your second question.
Oh.
That is, integrate from 0 to infinity, x square root x times e to the power of negative 2 square root x, dx.
Okay, so what should we do? Do that.
Of course. Or else, what are you waiting for?
Waiting for another Christmas?
So you need to find dx is what? Dy? Okay, so that is what you let, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so I didn't skip a step in this case. And plus, if you didn't see this let, what method do you think of other than substitution? What do you think of others?
Other than if you don't use substitution, I don't know what method are you going to use.
Of course, we don't do integral by parts, and that will get more and more complicated. Right?
Yeah.
And that will lead to a dead end, or else it's the same question again. You keep repeating the question.
So, continue.
Can I explain?
I don't get it at the first step. What happened there?
What?
What happened to the interpolar negative to the square root x?
Oh, yeah.
And next time, write it properly, okay?
Okay.
And you can also take all those over outside because they are all constants. Am I right?
No, of the opposite. So which function should we use? Should we use the beta? Since we are learning the beta?
And I don't think you can solve it there. Are you sure you can use the beta? There's an E there. Obviously you can think of that, Gemma.
Is it 3 or 5?
Think on your own.
I know, but in case they don't know. So it's actually a 5 because then this is a n minus 1. This is n.
Or you can also say that is an n, here is an n plus 1.
Okay. And still know that special case, can you write it down with what had gamma n equals to the special case?
Okay, so we prove that, right?
Uh-huh.
So we prove that anyways gamma, not gamma.
Gamma become gamma again. I mean gamma gamma.
Like this.
What I got is 3/2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2.
And that is the right answer.
Yay!
So you just simplify mentally, right?
Yes. Let's just say that here I got skip step, but here we also cannot use integral by part. Second method. As I said, integral by parts.
Whoa, you're gonna use integral by part? Do you think you can do this?
Yes, of course.
So you can use this part? In this second method that we'll use integral by part. Do you know how to solve for this? Well, you solve, I'll help you check. Okay, so right now for that x square root x, just think the denominator is a 1. So numerator, denominator times square root x. So that means you'll get an x squared over square root x. So inside that d, you'll have a dx still. So now, you want to try to put the e to the power of negative 2 square root x inside. So first, when you have this x squared over square root x, So I need to try to put that square root x inside. Wait. Here comes the wrong part. So first, each upon negative 2 square root x, then you times the x squared. So you first put the square root x inside. Now when you put that inside, you have a 2 square root x, right?
Yes.
So this 2 square root x, you have a negative. Then here we have a negative.
Okay.
Then you can put this in. Like this.
And what about your half?
Oh wait.
Okay.
So it becomes like this. Okay. Then I think you know how to continue, right?
Yes, integral by parts.
Yes, correct. Integral by parts. So, what do you have there? Wait a second, integral by parts.
Oops.
And here you have that square root. Okay, so you have that part. But right now, for this, when you start in infinity, it's because it's over infinity. So first, when you start it in, it's a zero. The next zero, when you start it in, it's still zero. So, don't have. It's a zero.
So here.
So you're left with this part. Then you differentiate for the x squared to come out. Okay. Then next, you need x to the power of 3 over 2 over square root x, right? So like that, another square root x can go in then. Pretty much the same thing, right? Then you need this, go inside. Now what's your problem?
Nothing.
Here, go inside. Thank you. Okay, so now you actually straight away put the whole thing in. Well, that was fast. So now, okay, you're using integral by parts. And I wonder what happened. Because at first this is inside that dx, right? So you should actually have written this as x to the power of 3 over 2, right?
So what's the method?
So when you differentiate this, you'll have a 3 over 2 times x to the power of half. And why do you have this? I seriously don't get it, why? Or is there an accident? Okay, that's much more like it.
Wait a second.
Then next, you need two of this. So two of this actually makes x, right?
Yep.
Then you over square root x. Is it the same?
Yes.
So now put that over square root x inside.
And here's a zero anyway.
Yes, correct, exactly. Here it's also a zero. So now you're using integral by parts, right? And what happens to the square x? It suddenly grow. Well, because at first it's on the power. How could it grow and come down? I think it's because when E is lifting it up, it grow bigger. E don't have enough strength.
And with it is a zero, not a six, not a theta.
Now, what do you want? Let me see. So, x efforts inside, differentiate, it's still a 3, what? Still a 3. Because x is only to the power of 1, so 1 take down, well, that doesn't matter. Right?
Yeah.
So, that means left is just a 1, right? Yeah, so 1 of the x, write that first. So that means you can write it as square root x over x. Square root x over x. I mean square root x over square root x. Right?
Square root x.
Over square root x. Sounds weird? Right? Does it sound weird?
Yeah.
So then, put one of this inside the dx. That you have a square root x, right? So that makes a half. So you have a 3 over 2. Then you integrate from 0 to infinity. So then you also have the e to the power of negative 2 square root x times, now this is special. You have 1 over square root x. Here dx. Then I just put this inside.
Wait a second.
Yes, is there any problem? So then put this inside. Oh well, never mind. It's actually a mistake, you take it out. But it's okay if you still take it out. Do you know why you can just don't take it out and leave it there?
Why?
Because you can just leave it inside and scroll X. And then you need a 2. So, is there anything wrong there? Wait a second. Negative. Yeah, there. Then you start from 0 to infinity, right? Then, wait, what? Now I want to ask you, why you don't have any more others?
Are you telling me to continue integral by parts?
Cannot, right? Cannot anymore, right? Okay, so that means we got the right answer.
Because if you continue integral by parts, it will be...
No, it is impossible. You can't continue. Right, yeah. So in this lesson, are you clear so far?
Yes.
So do you have any other questions or anything else to say?
No.
Okay, so if you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and we have more of these videos.
Okay.
So hope you like our videos. See you in the next lesson. So this is about beta and gamma function. Thank you for your watching.